This video talks about the conditional jump instruction. We'll see how jump instruction is used in a piece of program and the simulation of the CPU behavior. At the end, we see how the control unit implements this instruction. Jump instruction in low-level language are a way to permanently transfer the execution to another instruction located at the different memory address. Conditional jumps are used to take jumps based on the value of status flags, which we'll see later. Conditional jumps are commonly used when concepts like if statements and loops are needed to be used. Let's see an example of conditional jump used in a loop. This piece of program says that while A is less than 7, CPU executes instruction X and Y. This is a typical high-level piece of program, but let's see how we can translate it in our low-level language, the language we have created to represent SCOT CPU operations. Here you can see the translation. On the left, we put the address, and on the right, the program. You see, we put the number 7 in R1 and the number 1 in R0 with the data instruction. Beside, we imagine of having already put the variable A in R3. Then we compare R1 and R0, or A and 7, and then we use a conditional jump instruction. This jump instruction jumps if the result of the comparison is larger or equal, so if R3 is larger or equal 7. It jumps to address X outside the loop, but if R3 is less than R1 or A is less than 7, the condition is not met and we increment R3 with the add instruction and we perform the instruction X and Y. After instruction Y, we need an unconditional jump instruction because we have to come back to perform the loop. So we jump to address Y, where we execute the compare where the loop starts. As we have learned in previous videos, we can write the corresponding machine language. Here you can see the first data instruction, which takes 2 bytes. One for the instruction and the other for the data, the one in this case. Here the second data instruction for the number 7. Here there is the compare of R3 and R1. And here the conditional jump, which also takes 2 bytes. Then we have the add instruction, which add R0 to R3 and put the result in R3. Then we have the instruction X and Y, and at the end we have an unconditional jump which takes 2 bytes, being the last one the address in which we jump, so where there is the compare instruction. The CPU we are talking about is the SCOT CPU from the book But How Do It Know by J. Clare Scott. An instruction code is a group of bits that instructs the computer to perform a specific operation. An instruction can be divided in 2 parts. The first part is called opcode, and in the SCOT CPU we have 15 different operations. The second one is called address code, because it usually defines the address in which you can find operands or data, but in our case the 4 bits of the address code are used for the flags. The flags are 4 bits coming from the ALU, which tell us some information about the 2 operands of the ALU. The idea is using these bits as conditioning for the jump, so we use the address code to define the condition. The first bit of the address code defines the carryout condition, the second the A larger, the third the equal bit, and the fourth the 0. For example, in the instruction shown, we have A larger and A equal B. So the jump condition is met if first operand is larger than the second, or it is equal. Remember, it is needed a compare operation or an ALU operation before the conditional jump. We have 15 different combinations of conditional jump instruction in our low-level language. We see here an example of conditional jump. We see the first bit is 0, and in our CPU this means a not ALU instruction. The opcode is that of conditional jump, So, in the address code, we find the condition to meet. This machine code, or this instruction, states jump if A is larger or equal B, where A and B are two registers and are defined in an ALU operation we need before this jump operation. If the conditions are met, you have to jump to the address pointed out in the next byte. We call it byte X for simplicity. Remember, we have already built some important components of Scott's CPU, the RAM memory, the ALU, and we are building the control unit. At the heart of the control unit, there is the stepper, which gives the right sequence to all the operations. As we saw in previous video, we have 6 steps. In first 3 steps, we put on the bus the instruction address, increment it by 1, and fetch the instruction in the instruction register. In the second 3 steps, steps 4, 5, and 6, we execute the instruction. So this is a simulation of conditional jump instruction. You can see the bits A larger and A equal B are already on because they came from a previous ALU instruction. As we said in previous video, we use the first 3 steps to fetch and increment the instruction address register and steps 4, 5, and 6 to execute the instruction. We remember the memory is partly dedicated to the program and partly to the data. First, we put on the bus the instruction address register content and from there to the memory address register, so now we have the RAM address of our instruction selected. Simultaneously, being the instruction address on the bus, we activate bus 1 and being opcode to 000 by default, we perform an add operation incrementing by 1 the address of the instruction and putting the result in the accumulator register. As we said in MAR, there is the instruction address and we start to fetch the instruction in the IR or instruction register, where we decode it. In our case, it states to jump if A is larger or equal B. The last part of the first 3 steps is the moving of the next instruction address from accumulator to IAR. In this way, we memorize the next instruction address in IAR. Once the instruction is decoded, we start the execute part in steps 4, 5, and 6. In our case, we have first to put the IAR content on the bus and increment it by 1, and second, we have to acquire it from MAR register. Then we move the incremented byte from accumulator to IAR. In this moment, we have the second byte of the jump instruction memorized in MAR to point the address in which we have to jump in case the condition is met, and the address next the jump instruction in IAR to continue with the program in case the condition is not met. In our case, the condition is met, so we have to put the address in which we want to jump in IAR, overwriting the other address. In this situation, the next instruction will be at address 00000101 or 5 in decimal because we executed the jump. Now we see how to execute the conditional jump instruction in steps 4, 5, and 6. Here you see the logic circuit we need to execute this kind of jump instruction. First, note on the left, we have some wires coming from the flag register output fed from the ALU. Note the bits A for A larger and E for equal are on because this is the result of the previous compare instruction. Being our instruction code 0101 0110, we have the bit 7 of instruction register to 0, enabling all the AND gates and so the not ALU instruction section. Since bits 4, 5, and 6 are 101, we have the opcode for this jump instruction, and the 5th output of the decoder 328 is on, thus putting it in on the 5th AND gate of the decoder. Since we have at 1 bits A larger and equal in the instruction code, and since A and E bits coming from the ALU are in ON, we have in ON the output of the OR going to the AND tree gate. In this situation, when step 4 arrives, we put in ON the output of the AND 1, thus giving an enable pulse in IAR, putting the register content on the bus, and another enable pulse to bus 1, incrementing the IAR content. At the same time, we give a set pulse to register MAR, acquiring the IAR content, and a set pulse to accumulator, acquiring the result of the incrementing operation. When step 5 arrives, we give an enable pulse to accumulator, putting the byte on the bus, and a set pulse to IAR, acquiring the byte from the bus. In this situation, we have inside IAR the instruction address next the jump instruction, and we have register MAR pointing to the RAM with the address in which we have to jump if the condition is met. In step 6, we check if the condition is met. In this case, output of the OR is ON, so the output of AND 3 is ON as well, giving an enable pulse to RAM and a set pulse to IAR, overwriting IAR with the address in which we have to jump. Note, if OR output is OFF, condition is not met, and in step 6 nothing happens, thus leaving in IAR the address next the jump instruction to continue the program. Thank you for watching. Please leave me a comment and let me know if you liked this video. Make sure you put the thumb up, click the notification bell, and subscribe to my channel.